understood? And see, this one more lab program is here. I explain very slowly for you. Please listen to me with concentration. What is this given question? Write a C program to find roots of a quadratic equation. Okay, this one, I explain. Already we know how to find the roots of a quadratic equation. If you want to find the roots of a quadratic equation, we need to have three values, that means three coefficients A, B and C. We calculate the discriminant value B square minus 4AC. But to find the discriminant value B square minus 4AC, A should not be 0. If A is not 0, then only we calculate D value. What is that? B square minus 4AC. Once we find the discriminant value, there are three possibilities. That discriminant value might be greater than 0. This is first possibility. One more possibility. That discriminant value might be equals to 0. One more possibility. Not greater than 0, not equals to 0. One more possibility is that less than 0. If less than 0, machine follows. This is what you can see here. In this if, one more if is used. This is nested if. And see here, this is else if ladder has been used. To solve this problem, nested if we are using as well as else if ladder we are using. If A not equals to 0, okay, then machine calculates the D value. Assume that D is greater than 0. Machine follows these many instructions. Assume that not greater than 0, then machine will check for equals to 0. If equals to 0, machine follows these instructions. Assume that not greater than 0, not equals to 0, then definitely that will be less than 0. Don't check the condition here. Not greater than, not equals to, means definitely less than 0. Then it follows it. One of the three choices works here. We have three choices. First one, second one, third one. Okay. Now I explain slowly. Assume that entered A value is not 0. Yes. D is calculated. Yes. D is greater than 0. Yes. Roots are real and distinct. Okay. What is the formula? Minus B plus square root of B square minus 4AC. B square minus 4AC already be stored in D. Okay. Minus B plus square root of D. See, the brackets is very important here. This is numerator part inside the parenthesis divided by 2a. R1, that means root 1 is calculated. SQRT is one mathematical function available in math.h. So you need to add math.h here. So you need to add which header file? Math.h. Sorry. So that's why I added here math.h. In this math.h, SQRT is available as well as ABS is available. ABS will convert the value from negative to positive. Okay. It is available in math.h. If you won't add that math.h, you cannot use it. SQRT will find the square root of a given value. It is also available in math.h only. If you won't add math.h, this will not work. That's why we add math.h. I hope you understood. I continue. If D is greater than 0, roots are real and distinct. R1 will be calculated like this. R2 will be calculated. Minus B minus square root of B square minus 4 is divided by 2A. R1 is having the root 1. R2 is having the root 2. We print. Cursor moves to next line. Root 1 equals to percentage of slash T. Horizontal tab means horizontal gap we get. Okay. And root 2 equals to percentage of R1 comma R2. Means if D is greater than 0, machine will print nature of roots as roots are real and distinct. R1 is calculated by machine. R2 is calculated by machine. R1 and R2 are displayed by machine. Program completes. Assume that D is not greater than 0. Then machine will check whether D is equals to 0. Let us assume yes. D is equals to 0. That means roots are real and equal. R1 will be calculated like this. Minus B upon 2A. This is what the root 1. Then root 2 will become root 1. roots are real and equal, R1 only becomes R2. Then you have to print on terminal, print F, cursor moves to next line, root 1 equals to 1 value, where is it? In R1, slash T, gap we get. Using this slash T is not compulsory, even you can use the space also. Root 2 equals to percentage F, this is for R2. Like this, if D is greater than equals to 0, machine follows these 4 instructions. Let us assume D is not greater than 0 also, D is not equals to 0 also, means what? Definitely less than 0, then this else block works. Roots are imaginary. R1 equals to minus B upon 2A. R2, how to calculate? Discriminant value you have to convert into positive. If that is negative, that will be converted into negative. If that is negative, that will be converted into positive. We find the square root of it, then divided by 2a. This is having R1 value and this is having R2 value. How to print the imaginary roots? As we know in mathematics, to print the imaginary roots, we use plus I and minus I. Before plus I, R1 will come. After plus I, R1 will come. This is root 1. Before minus I, R1 will come. After minus I, R1 will come. This is root 2. Anyhow, we have R1 and R2. Means it displays root 1 equals to R1 plus I, R2. For these two percentage of R1 and R2. For these two percentage of R1 and R2. That means I get root 1 equals to root 1 plus I, root 2. Root 2 equals to root 1 minus I, root 2. Like this, the output will be displayed by the developed program or the software on the terminal. Assume that entered A value is 0. Entered A value is 0, we cannot find the roots. A is not equals to 0? No, A is equals to 0. That means I cannot find. Then else block will work. In the else box, coefficients are not non-zero. That's why I cannot give you the results. Given coefficients do not form a quadratic equation. You can print that message also. Then the program completes. I think now you have understood. It is very easy program. Now I explain in hurry. Okay. First we have to add a header file, stdio.h. Then we have to add math.h. Then void main, A, B, C, 3 coefficients, R1, R2, root 1 and root 2. And these are discriminant value. You can change the order also. Read the 3 coefficients. Enter 3 coefficients of a quadratic equation. Percentage of. I am reading 3 coefficients. If A not equals 0, then only this entire code works. If A is 0, only this works. Program completes. If A is not equals to 0, then discriminant will be calculated. According to the contents of discriminant value, that might be greater than 0, that might be equals to 0, that might be less than 0. I think you have understood. Okay. Now, if you have understood, it is well and good. If not, please watch this video once again slowly. Have a nice day. Take care. Thank you.